Hey all, it's Crazy Mama Kelly coming at you from my part of PA. Well, I figured I'd make a video before I head into work again. this video I'm going to title, it's called The Seven Gates of Hell. We're going to talk about it. It comes out of the book. You can find it in Weird PA Book, and you can also find it in the Big Book of Pennsylvania Ghost Stories, this book. Okay. So it says that Pennsylvania seems to have a lot of sites that are endowed with demonic sightings and areas and stuff. And this is just like one of any other. It's called the Seven Gates of Hell. And it's in a place, excuse me, I gotta make, I'm making close soap. Sorry about that. Yeah, I'm making close soap. It's called Seven Gates of Hell. This takes place in York. It takes York and takes place in York County. It's a little. The reason why it's called Seven Gates of Hell is one of the reasons they think is it's near a small town. The historical information is called it's Hallam. Is Hallam in York? It's near the town of Hallam in York County. Hallam, however, did not start out so innocently. Originally, the name was the town was called Hell's Town. Okay, and it was the township was created in 1730. Just outside the edge of the original settlement was a sulfur pit, and people used to smell, see the boiling brimstone, immediately thought of hell. So it didn't take long the area become known as Hell's Town. Okay, the name changed because of bureaucratic typo. One of the clerks wrote down the name wrong. Instead of putting it as Helltown, he put it he wrote it down as Hallman, like Hallam, Hallmantown. So it kind of just kind of stuck. Instead of calling it Hellstown, it became Hallam, and Hallam, but it's still located in the township of Hellman. So get that what you will. Okay. Off of Trout Run Road in Hallam Township, Hallam Township is a track and it's barred by Red Pipe Barn Gate. And there's no trespassing signs all around it. People insist if you insist on walking the trail, despite the gates signs, you're going to come to a total of seven gates. Okay. And these are said to be the seven gates that guard the path into hell. Okay, in the 1800s, the trail was lit road led to a remote compound composed of a large building and several small buildings, and that was a sane asylum. And it housed hundreds of inmates. And everybody really didn't like the idea of having dangerous, potentially dangerous people, in their backyards. They weren't real pleased about this whole place. And it made me, and people had ill feelings. There were rumors about rampant escapes in the area of insane people and damage done by the inmates, because they weren't right. In all likelihood, a lot of these stories weren't true or were true. But the rumors turned otherwise. Nice people and the suspicious neighbors, they weren't cool with it. Okay. Said one night the building caught fire and the local fire department was called in. From the beginning it was like not a good thing at all because the heavy equipment couldn't make it take the path that led up to the sane asylum. It was a deep trek into the woods. And the staff says did their were too busy trying to get the inmates out. I mean, they were trying to get all the inmates out they possibly could because there were like hundreds there. And the first few floors were literally turned out on their own into the woods, just so they could work on getting the other people because it was probably hectic, crazy madness going on, The ones in the upper floors of the compound weren't so lucky. A lot of them were trapped and died from smoke inhalation and also from the flames of the blaze. And I guess it was a terrible sight, and you could smell the stench of burning flesh, and it was gagging people. The firemen worked to contain the blaze, but it was too late for those upon the upper floors. Well over 100 people died, and many others were severely burned. The following day, the townsfolk began a roundup of the patients. And the stories are some of the stories say that some of the patients were beaten so badly by the groups that were assigned to bring them back, you know, and that others even claim that some of the inmates were killed by the people, that fearful townsfolk that were meant to get them. They moved the inmates away. The asylum was never rebuilt because, like I said, they weren't happy with it. But I guess it's the property set derelict for many years. Eventually, townsfolk decided to gate the place up to block curious viewers from the site. So they kept on adding more and more gates. So in all total, now that there's 7 gates, and they call it 7 gates of hell. They say once you get to the first gate, you start getting a fear like something's not right, you shouldn't be here. And then another, when you get to the second gate, as you pass the first one, you feel like you should turn back. Okay, and when you go to the second gate, it feels like you're being watched or there's pending great danger. When you gradually rise to the second, third gates are passed. Okay. And when you get to the fourth gate, if you're lucky enough, you get real fear begins. And then when you get, and then those foolhardily to go to the fifth and sixth and seventh gates, they get the urge to run and they just want to leave. They get overwhelmed feeling like they need to get out of there. And if you happen upon, nobody's gotten as far as to the seventh gate. Nobody's gotten there. And the people, nobody knows if anybody's gotten past the seventh gate because they say once you get past seventh gate, you're leading into hell. Nobody's had proof that that's a gateway to hell. Nobody has proof of that. But it's just hearsay, rumors, you know. I would say definitely, I mean, there's no reports. Nobody's ever reported feelings of hauntings or anything like that. But a lot of the patients, some of the patients that were wandering the woods probably did not make it back. I mean, they're totally out of their capacity to know, you know, anything because they're supposed to be insane. That's the reason why they're there. And I don't know if there was rumors of lobotomies or anything there that, but early in the 1800s, I think that's when, I'm not sure when the lobotomies started, but I know they started a process like that. The insane weren't treated so well back then. They still really, I mean, modern psychology's come a long way, but there's a lot of barbaric treatments of insane people back then. So I don't know. So there's possibility maybe that place could be haunted. I'm not sure. But being that it's gated off by 7 gates, they're really not wanting people to go back there. So if you're driving past that way, you see the 7 gates hell, then you see it. But I wouldn't recommend going there, especially if the townsfolk have it gated so much. They probably really don't want you back there. They don't know what's back there. So for your own safety and well-being, maybe you shouldn't go back there. Because you never know, there could be some insane spirits back there that might mess you up. Or drag you to hell, because that's supposed to be the gateway to hell, but there was never proof. So that was my story. I hope you enjoyed it. So it's the 7 gates of hell, right here in our little PA. Kind of interesting, the things you find in this state of ours. Well, that's it for me. I want to let you know also that I started an Etsy shop. It's called Crazy Mom Kelly. I'll try to put the link below if I remember to, but if you're on Etsy one night and just chilling, I'll have all sorts of little trinkets I sell on my shop. I only have like one post up so far, but I plan on doing more. I do dream catchers. I do candles. This is just one of the candles I bought. Ooh, never mind. Not this one, I guess, but it's called Little Pots of Love. I have rose quartz in here. It's apple cinnamon scent. There's rose quartz in here, rose quartz crystal chips. There's cinnamon sticks and the apple smells, apple cinnamon smell. There's a little bit of pink glitter in there because everybody needs a little sparkle in their life. Hey, but I do dream catchers too, and I'll be doing crocheting hats and stuff when I get a free chance. I'll also do hats and everything. So it's going to be Crazy Mom Kelly store on Etsy. I appreciate all my subscribers. I really feel some love. I'm glad, you know, you guys watch my crazy ass. I love doing these stories, and I continued up. Someday, hopefully, I could possibly go to some of these sites and show you what I'm talking about. Maybe. Summer's been kind of chewed up with work and everything, you know. Gotta make that money. All right, well, blessings all. Take care, peace, and bye-bye.